Thank you very much, Mr. Bakshi, for setting the tone for the first ever Global CEO Conference. Well, ladies and gentlemen, as we were discussing the impact of social media, may I also inform that all of you can follow on Twitter the ISA VUCA handle, which is @ISA_VUCA, and you can also use the hashtag, #ISAVUCA, to follow the tweets. Well, ladies and gentlemen, before we move ahead, it's now time to take a look at the audiovisuals from our partners. This time, our gold partner, Zee Entertainment Enterprises Limited, and silver partner, ABB. Please take a look.
Zee Entertainment is a part of the ESSEL Group, India's leading business conglomerate, having a diverse business presence across media, entertainment, packaging, infrastructure, education, and technology sectors. The journey of 1,000 miles began with a single step in 1976. He is none other than Mr. Subhash Chandra. It was his pioneering farsightedness that gave India its first private satellite channel, ZTV. Zee Entertainment Enterprises Limited has been the biggest success story in the over $13 billion Indian media and entertainment industry. Mr. Chandra's dream and his aspirations to make it big transformed a small company into a media and entertainment giant. Zee Entertainment started India's first private channel, ZTV, the first channel dedicated to beaming Hindi content, in 1992. Having dedicated channels covering the entire spectrum of general entertainment, news, sports, and movies, it now has become one of the most watched entertainment brands due to its innovative and ever-evolving approach to producing as well as acquiring content that appeals to the taste of their audiences worldwide. For the best in entertainment, there is only one answer, one choice. Zee Entertainment.
Ladies and gentlemen, and with that, may I now invite media entrepreneur, Mr. Anurag Batra, Chairman and Editor-in-Chief of the Exchange for Media Group, to please address the August gathering. Let's have a warm round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Mr. Anurag Batra.
Thank you. It's my honor and privilege to be amongst you today. I'd like to thank ISA, and I'd like to acknowledge some of the ISA Executive Council members here for giving us an opportunity at Exchange for Media to partner this prestigious event. I can only tell you that there are at least 50 people who've flown in from Delhi just for the event. It tells you about the quality of content that the members have put together. So I'd like to acknowledge Mr. Hemant Pakshi, the chairman of ISA. And Hemant, your speech was really a reflection of what's happening in the country. And in spite of slow growth rates elsewhere, India continues to grow. I would also like to acknowledge Mr. Bharat Patel, the past chairman of ISA, who's really, as Hemant said, been a guiding spirit. Ms. Palomi, the one who's really worked behind the scenes to make today's conference happen. Mr. Narendra Ambani. I know Anisha Motwani is not here, but I'd like to acknowledge her. Also like to acknowledge the presence of some of our esteemed speakers. Mr. R. Gopalakrishnan is there. Mr. Brahm Masudev is here. Mr. Chopra is here. And my friends, fellow entrepreneurs, and media colleagues. Hemant has outlined the theme of the conference very well, given perspective, so I have very little to say. But I'd like to say five things. One is my favorite Hindu mythology example. We are talking about entrepreneurship. We are talking about navigating a VUCA world. And for an entrepreneur, every day is a VUCA world. And entrepreneurship thrives in VUCA, because when there is volatility, there's uncertainty, there's complexity, there are opportunities. When people shut down businesses, other people start businesses. I believe that VUCA environment is a perfect environment for Indian entrepreneurs to grow. Indian entrepreneurs have thrived in such an environment. Second, as I said, the Hindu mythology, I talk about the Hindu trilogy of Vishnu, Shiva, Brahma. Really, we like to do creative destruction. I think we as Indians are very critical on us. We are very reflective. We are very sensitive. I think we are far too critical of what we do in India than probably other people are of us. So I think it's time to be donning the hat of Shiva and doing some destruction before we can be a creator. I think it's time for a lot of entrepreneurs. And when I say entrepreneurs, I mean people like him and who are running companies. And really, the companies have grown because the managers at the helm of the affairs have been very entrepreneurial. Second, and I see some media CEOs and entrepreneurs in this room, I'd like to say is that really, like in every other business, I say Lakshmi and Saraswati have to go hand in hand. We're in the business of creating content, which is in some way Saraswati. If we do that well, Lakshmi will follow. And that is probably applicable to every business and every business owner in this room. Third, you know, Hemant talked about everything, but one thing I'd like to talk about is lack of governance in this country. I think as an entrepreneur, the most important thing is we as business leaders, and there are business leaders in this room who can make an impact on the leaders that run the country. I think we as entrepreneurs have to demand and seek better governance. Fourth, and I can't, it's not a very good name, so I won't give you the hashtag handle, but there is a hashtag handle which says there is no recession. You can Google. So where is the recession in India? It gives you numbers of how many cars being sold, how FMCG companies are doing. So I think media has in some way exaggerated the reality of recession. In fact, in some industries, there are growths that have never been seen. Yes, telecom industry, media industry, and some allied industries may be under pressure, automobiles, but most of other industries continue to gallop. So as I said, we are very harsh on ourselves. India is growing, and it is going to be even better than what it is today in the years to come. Last but not the least, Hemant talked about the social impact of businesses, sustainability. We as entrepreneurs are too worried about bottom line, top line, growth, market share. I think Unilever has done some pioneering work, and I hope that Mr. Paulman shares some of what Unilever is doing in the world. A lot of Indian companies have done pioneer work in terms of sustainability quietly. So I think as leaders in the room, that's an area as a company we'd like to focus on. As an entrepreneur, I'm interested, and I'm sure as an audience, you're interested, because as Hemant talked about going from abundance to lack of resources, sustainability is something that will make sure that we are profitable and we are karmically okay. Thanks for partnering with Exchange for Media, and I look forward to having a great day amongst all of you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Batra, for sharing your valuable insights with all of us. Ladies and gentlemen, as we're about to begin our sessions, before we do so, it's also time to take a look at some of the audio visuals of our silver partner, ABP News, broadcast partner, ET Now, and co-partner, Lakshya Media.
What makes a leader? It's the passion for excellence, the vision to innovate, and values. They are the ones who forge new paths for others to follow. In the Indian newscape, with over 100 odd TV channels, there's one network that demonstrates leadership. ABP Network. With three leading news channels, ABP News, ABP Ananda, ABP Majha, with innovative, impactful and differentiated programming that has truly changed the realm of newscasting. Our passion for excellence is truly reflected in the programs that voice the electoral choice of the masses. Kaun Banega Mukhyamantri and Kaun Banega Pradhan Mantri, the most comprehensive political shows with 7 years of consistent leadership. Ghoshna Patra, a candid one-to-one chat that brings together the people and their future leaders.
Ghoshna Patra banne ki prakriya prarambh ho gayi hai.
Our vision lies in presenting the programs like no one else. Pradhan Mantri, a chronicle of Indian history through the stories of its prime ministers.
Dekhiye zarur Pradhan Mantri.
Programs that usher in a change in the citizens and the society.
Ispe chuppi todna bahut zaruri hai taki hum ispe rok lagaye.
Asar, a cutting-edge show that made an impact by measuring the impact of another show. Second Opinion, a nationwide mission to enlighten people about medical negligence and treatment.
Prashant Akhir, wheelchair par kaise?
Let's Fly the Flag, an inspiring initiative that celebrates the Indian spirit of patriotism across the world. News Positive, a regular news bulletin that believes in spreading cheer and hope through positive news. Our value for existence is to bring change and impact the society at large by engaging the mass and spurring a movement. Ganga Ki Saugandh, a mass crusade since the last 3 years to save the sanctity of the Ganges. We not only report but also help, like Missing in Uttarakhand, an extensive initiative that became the clarion call to help the Uttarakhand victims. 10 innovative shows, 10 inspiring ideas, 1 relentless drive to continue being the numero uno, not just in ratings, popularity and profitability, but also in thought leadership. ABP Network, India's number one news network.
ABP News, aapko rakhe aage.
When you seek the India story, you ought to know the vision of India Inc. Get the views and perspectives from the biggest names of India Inc., bringing you the real world of business. To catch the best of India Inc., now is the time, and this is the channel.
And with that, ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to begin the enriching sessions in store for all of you. Each session will be followed by the Q&A round, for which I'm going to request the members of the audience who have the questions for our speakers to please write them down on a piece of paper along with their name and the company name. The moderator for each session will be picking the questions. May I also request the members of the audience to ensure that the questions lays focus on the conference theme. In our first session, we have with us our speaker, our very eminent speaker, Mr. R. Gopalakrishnan, director, Tata Sons, who's also a well-known author, and he'll be speaking on India's VUCA movement. His view is that Indians are better equipped to deal with the VUCA world as they've always been to deal with adversity. Ladies and gentlemen, our moderator for this session is Mr. Brahm Vasudeva, non-executive chairman of the board of directors, Hawkins Cookers Limited. With a warm round of applause, please help me welcome on stage our moderator for the session, Mr. Brahm Vasudeva, and our speaker for the session, Mr. R. Gopalakrishnan.